dive into the Ducks a little bit more with you. It's a franchise you know very well.
I used to work for them too. I'll take credit for building it from the ground up. I was there 93, 94, the first iteration of the, well, let's call them the Anaheim Mighty Ducks.
You know what? We buried the lead in talking about Anaheim, Stu. As you mentioned that, bringing back the old logo and the colors.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's the biggest acquisition. That's the biggest news of the offseason.
Work a little eggplant into the mix. And I love to see my former number one netminder, the first ever one netminder for the franchise way back when, Guy Hebert, ends up being a jersey model late in his career. I love to see that.
But this Pacific Division, we have the Pacific Division Needs Show coming up this weekend. It's going to be a fun one in the Pacific. How would you put the Ducks in the power ranking right now? Because, listen, if you can't beat the champs without beating the champs, that's baseball nights in the Pacific. So where would you slide Anaheim?
You know, it's interesting. And the Ducks really have. They've had this strong core for a healthy number of years. And I'm left feeling like the coming season is one to – there's a healthy level of optimism to look at these Ducks with for the following reason. I go back to John Gibson. You put a good player in a contract year, his platform year, you're going to get results. And you're going to get results from Gibson at the most important position. It's goal attending for the Anaheim Ducks. And I liked Eric's comments, and I tend to agree with him. You need an infusion of something new and dynamic there. I think you get that from Henrique. I think you get that from a healthy Patrick Eves.
Ricard Raquel.
I think you get that from Ricard Raquel, now at a position in his career where he's in a position to embrace more, willing to take on more. And I think it helps drive the veterans like Getzlaf, like a Corey Perry, like a Ryan Kesler. As strong as these guys have been, playoff performers all, I think it's just going to be a really healthy, exciting mix of what's to come for the Ducks.
It's not talking about it is not a sign of disrespect to Ryan Getzlaf, Corey Perry, who's meant an immense amount to this organization. But this is the same conversation that's happening in Chicago, right? As those core pieces get older, they just can't carry the load the way they once did.
Can't carry the load the way they once did, so they look to other areas. The Ducks will look to other areas of the roster for the support to come, the depth to come. The forwards I've just mentioned, cast the spotlight, shine the spotlight on the defense position. Josh Manson, I think, is a guy that he's proven that he's capable of being a top four defender in this league, but he's a great big body, a very skilled puck handler, and a top-end skater. All in the package of, again, this above-average size frame reminds me of his father in an era gone by. But this is a guy, I think, that will make a deeper contribution this year as well.
So the Ducks trying to get back to the top of the Pacific Division Mountain.